I'm going to show you the easiest way to crop and resize video clips using PowerDirector. Let's crop out the crap. I have a clip of a lady doing yoga, and I want to crop out all of the extra space around her. Now, if you want to crop and resize the video, it's easy as 1, 2, 3. Left click on the clip that you want to go ahead and crop. Go to Tools. Go to Crop Zoom Pan. And then you can place your cursor over any of the nodes, hold down your left mouse, and drag it in to the position that you want. If you need to change the center of the image, place your cursor over this blue dot till you see these crosshairs, hold down your left mouse button, and drag the image where you want it to be. Then when you're done, go ahead and click on OK. So it's cropped it and automatically resized it to fit within the aspect ratio of the screen. If you want to crop the video and leave it the same size, I got the solution for that as well. We'll go ahead and undo this. And now we want to go ahead and left click on Tools. And we're going to go to Mask Designer. We want to make sure that you're on the Mask tab, and you want to make sure that you're under Mask Properties. Under Mask Properties, you want to go all the way up to the top and choose the square mask. Then we can close the mask properties and we can open object settings. And we're going to go and uncheck where it says maintain aspect ratio. And now we're going to go ahead and drag the nodes to the positions that we want. And now we can go ahead and click on OK. And now we've cropped it and we kept it the same size as it was originally, but we got a lot of black space around it. So if you want to, you can go ahead and add something to the background to fill in that blank space. So we're gonna go here and we're gonna drag this clip down and we're gonna place it on a track above it so that it's behind it. And then now we wanna go ahead and make any adjustments to the image that we cropped. So we can double left click on the image that we cropped. And then we can go ahead and go to the scale section. We can scale it down some. We can use our cursor here. We can drag it in the position that we want it to be in. And then if we want a border around it, we can scroll down and we can go ahead and click on border. And if we're done, we can click on OK. The Mask Designer can be used to make a lot of different things, including cool transitions. And you can learn how to make one by watching this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.